What happens 6 days past ovulation?
That's day 20 for most women's menstrual cycles, which puts you 7 to 10 days away from your period starting.
I know the schedule, I don't know what is going on internally.
If you are using natural family planning, you should know this is a perfectly safe time to have sex. Now and for the next few days.
I use other contraceptive measures that don't rely on charting bodily functions.
If you were trying to conceive and were tracking basal body temperature, the temperature would be the degree higher phase up through your period.
I know body temperature spikes the day you ovulate.
If you ovulated and didn't conceive, the egg is totally disintegrated by now. If you conceived, it should be through the fallopian tube and settling down somewhere.
I think it is still a week before any pregnancy tests would work.
Blood-based pregnancy tests would show up in a couple days. Early urine pregnancy tests in a week at the earliest.
And a few days after that, my period or lack thereof could give me that information.
Remember that high stress can delay your period.
Only if it delayed ovulation in the first place.
When you ovulated, the female hormones were high and it turned cervical mucus clear and watery. It shifts back to white and thick after you ovulate.
That's because the female hormones are declining.
There's a slight rise around day 21. About now, though it will start to decline again.
The complementary hormone used in birth control is actually very high right now, though it starts to drop around day 24 or day 28.
Day 28 with that hormone drop off is what causes your period to start.
And why the lack of that hormone in the birth control pill off week makes you have a period.
The hormones that offset the ones that cause the follicle to develop are peaking about now.
Talk about trivia.
The ovaries are still in the luteal phase.
That's anything past the date of ovulation, kind of like the uterine lining being in the secretory phase until my period starts. Then it is officially menses.
If you may have conceived, you could see implantation bleeding when the embryo implants.
That is at most a few drops of red, sometimes brown mixed with cervical mucus, and not always even that.
And if you are going to see that, it may be a day or three yet.
Then the pregnancy hormones start to get produced.
It would be days before that shows up in any blood test, a week before it shows up in a urine test.
What else is going on?
You aren't going to have breast tenderness, uterine pains or anything else you might have had when female hormones were high, though they can show up when the pregnancy hormones start to spike.
Which is still days away if ever.
So now you're down to steady state until there's some indication of any change, other than the routine cycle of your period.
At which point, I know exactly what the hormones do to me.